Thank you. Thank you. Oh, in thy meekness. This man has done nothing of it.
And he said unto Jesus,
Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom.
And
Psalm 119 says, "Your statutes are my heritage forever. They are the joy of my heart. The law from your mouth is more precious to me than thousands of pieces of silver and gold. How much more when those statutes and the word of God is sung to us with such exquisite and well-trained voices." And my name's Julie Blinko-Smith. I'm the senior minister here. And I wanted to give an incredible thanks first to the choir for their well-trained voices, their incredible practice, and the blessing they've been to us today. Let's give them a round of applause. And also, I'd love to thank James and Leighton. What a treat to be in the front row watching your well-trained voices bless us with the word of God today. Thank you for coming and for joining and for just delivering this beautiful Easter message on Palm Sunday. Let's give them a round of applause. heart a treat and a blessing. And thank you too for Bruce, who has led on organ for many years now as a treat to Greensboro and to minister the word of God to many through music and through the word of God. Thank you to Bruce and his team. You are all invited for afternoon tea today. Christine from our bookshop has prepared some scones and some afternoon tea. But before we head out there, I would like to read and pray a blessing. It's a prayer that St. Paul wrote to the Ephesians, and it's particularly suitable. It talks about the love of Jesus, how appropriate on this particular day. For this reason, I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth derives its name. I pray that out of his glorious riches, he may strengthen you with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all the Lord's holy people to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Let's give them one more round of applause and then we'll head out.